This Fire Ant Queen has traveled for miles on her nuptial flight, finally landing atop a sandy mound deep in the swamp. The vantage point might seem like an ideal home, but it may be short-lived. This whole area is liable to flooding, and nearby rainfall is already causing the groundwater to rise. Exhausted and without her wings, the Queen is unable to move on alone. But if she can amass enough daughters in time, the colony as a whole may stand a chance. Many nearby creatures have already been washed out of their homes by the rising water. A lucky few have been deposited on the shores east of the nest. As more arrive, tensions will rise. There isn't space here for everyone. A great blue skimmer, Libellula vibrans, hunts overhead. This fantastic aerial predator shouldn't cause any trouble for the ants. That is, unless it decides to land in their way. Food is abundant, but as the floodwater begins to rise, the ants will quickly lose access to the lower lands.
Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected.
Thank you.
an ant has found itself entangled on the sticky tentacle of a dwarf sundew. As it tries to struggle free, more tentacles are drawn in, drowning the victim in thick mucilage. The boggy earth at the base of the mound is now saturated, and as night approaches, the water begins to creep closer. The new arrivals will rush to higher ground, heading straight for the nest. There is nowhere else to go.
The ants will fight to the death. The queen is in imminent danger.
Amongst the melee of panicking creatures are larvae of the false bombardier beetle. Already large and accomplished predators, they will hold their ground against small groups of ants.
The queen is in imminent danger.
The inundation has slowed, and fewer creatures are washing up to the east. The ants have an opportunity to explore for food, but there are other dangers at night. Moist-skinned amphibians have come out to take advantage of this new water world, harvesting lost insects displaced from their burrows.
There are intruders in the nest.
A Pinewoods tree frog, Gila femoralis, has wandered into the trail. This one has taken a break from mate calling for a quick meal, and it seems that ants are on the menu. Continued rainfall is about to bring another torrent flushing through the bog, carrying with it a slew of ill-tempered arthropods.
Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected.
An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant.
The battle has begun. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The ants must protect the queen. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected.
With nowhere to drain, the floodwater creeps ever nearer to the nest. Already cramped and irritated, a panic ensues, and the refugees scramble for higher ground.
The ants will fight to the death.
Thank you.
News of the insect feast has spread across the swamp. With growing numbers of amphibians patrolling the waters, the Invictor's scavenging expeditions will need to be well defended. An eastern newt, Notophthalmus viridations, is devouring ants. Growing up to 10 centimeters in length, it dwarfs other creatures on the mound. Its red skin is toxic and serves as a warning to potential predators. A colony of little black ants marooned on a smaller section of the mound may be reachable if the fire ants join together to bridge the gap.
The ants will fight to the death. The battle has begun.
As if the colony didn't already have enough to deal with, the Great Blue Skimmer has chosen this moment to touch down right outside the nest. Unchecked, this titan of the sky will no doubt disrupt colony activities. But if the soldiers are able to bring her down, the rewards could be mighty. After a sustained assault from the fire ants, the Skimmer's stamina is beginning to wane. She leaps away from battle and prepares to take off. If the ants want to prevent her escape, they'll need to act quickly. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant. Her wings weighted down with fire ants, the Skimmer no longer has the strength to take off. Crippled by relentless stings, the Great Skimmer's attempts to flee became ever more futile. Finally collapsing atop the mound, she succumbs to the fire ants. Dismemberment will follow. Thank you.
the battle has begun.
As the water draws ever nearer, more insects begin to wash up on the bank. The Invicta colony must maintain control or risk being overrun.
The battle has begun. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected.
An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant.
Thank you.
The ants must defend themselves.
Again, the floodwaters rise. The washed-up invertebrates panic, and a stampede ensues. The Invicta soldiers must form ranks quickly.
The ants must fight. The ants must fight.
The Monomorium Black Ant colony is soon to be flooded. This is the fire ants' last chance to raid their nest. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant.
The colony is starving. There's not enough food to feed the new brood. The pond continues to swell, finally drowning the Monomorium colony. The fire ants watch as it sinks into the murky depths, foreshadowing their own demise.
Thank you.
Another surge advances, spreading a desperate frenzy throughout the beached survivors. The Invicta colony must leave now or prepare their last stand.
The ants must fight.
Time has run out. The Invicta colony must gather atop the mound. They won't get another chance.
The battle has begun. The colony is starving. There's not enough food to feed the new brood.
By joining their bodies together to form a giant raft, the fire ants were able to ferry the queen from the mound just as the nest filled with water. Their perils are not over, but they have shown great resilience and an ability to survive in this harsh environment. Wherever they land, the creatures of the swamp will quickly come to know the might of the fire ants.